Margaret, concordia. Taoiseach, as temperatures fall below freezing point this week, the plight of our homeless citizens, particularly those forced to sleep on the streets, takes on an even sharper focus. And today there's a day-long protest outside the Dáil. It's organised by My Name Is, and I commend everyone involved. And they're holding this protest because they care. They're holding this protest because you are refusing to take the necessary actions to end this scourge on our society. Homelessness in this state is now at emergency levels. It's an alarming reality that over 8,000 of our citizens, including over 3,000 children, are homeless as Christmas approaches. 8 people died on our streets since August. That's not acceptable by any standard, by any measure, by any statistic, or by any report, national or international, that you may reference. Imagine, Taoiseach, being without a home at any time. Níl aon tin-tán mar de tin-tán féin mar a deirtear in Yielga. Go haraha ag nollag. So imagine being without a home, without even a stable, at Christmas. And there are parts of this state where there are no emergency beds, no facilities that are suitable for some citizens forced to sleep on the streets. Now, you often claim that no one in this Dáil has a monopoly on compassion, and that's true. And of course, there are complexities about all of this, but nothing as complex as the issues that a homeless person faces in the struggles of their daily lives. Results count, Taoiseach. You lead the government. A truly compassionate government would implement compassionate policies that would make a real difference in the lives of homeless citizens. Taoiseach, the housing agency was offered 1,800 vacant turnkey homes to purchase in the last year. 1,800. These offers came from banks, from funds, from others. These homes could be bought and families could move into them immediately. Of the 1,800 homes, the government has agreed to buy only 600. Now, I accept that perhaps not all these homes are suitable, but it's hard to believe the 1,200 are unsuitable. So I don't believe that the government thinks there's a housing emergency. If you did believe this, you would not waste any opportunity to house citizens. People are dying on the streets, children are spending their childhoods in emergency accommodation, and families are losing hope on housing waiting lists. So, Taoiseach, will you explain to the Dáil why you are purchasing only 600 of the 1,800 homes on offer? Can you also explain why it's taken so long to purchase and allocate those homes which you have bought to allocate those to families? And will you tell us what you're going to do to ensure that no citizen is forced to sleep on the streets? Gordon Margaret.
I'd have to get back to you, Deputy, on the detailed numbers in relation to those homes. I think that was some time ago, and at the time, if I recall correctly, a number of those homes were not in areas where there was a high level of demand for social housing, so they couldn't, they weren't all suitable, as you acknowledged yourself, for social housing, but I'll certainly get the details on that and give you a detailed answer by correspondence. In terms of the general issue that you raise, I want to say that the government cares a lot about homelessness, not just at this time of the year, but at all times of the year, and I care a lot about it too as Taoiseach. I said before that I consider homelessness to be a stain on our society, and we need to do everything that we can to reduce it and eliminate it, if possible, in the months and years ahead. I've taken the opportunity in the last week or two to visit a family hub, to meet with some of the homeless families who live there, and also to meet some rough sleepers and to try to understand a little bit better their experience and the experiences that they face. So the kind of actions that the government is taking is an €18 million increase in the budget for homelessness services next year. That brings the budget up to 118 million. The number of families who are in B&Bs and hotels is down substantially from when it peaked last spring because of the development of family hubs, and there are many more coming on stream. And in terms of emergency beds for rough sleepers, an additional 200 are being put in place over these number of weeks, ensuring that there is an emergency bed available for everyone who needs one, not just this Christmas, but into the new year, over the winter period, and into the spring and summer as well. And there's a particular effort being made to encourage people to come into those new beds. And bear in mind, these are single rooms and double rooms. They're not dormitories. So just to give you an example, on Sunday night, which was a very cold night. An analysis was done, and major efforts were made in the Dublin region to make sure that all rough sleepers had the option of emergency beds. And on Sunday night, after a huge effort being made by the staff of the Dublin Regional Homeless Executive and others, 10 beds for females were unused, and there was a male bed vacancy, and nobody was not placed. So we do know that as recently as Sunday night, there was adequate capacity in the system to provide an emergency bed in Dublin for every man or woman who wanted one. And we will continue to increase capacity over the next couple of weeks so that we can ensure that there is an emergency bed for anyone who needs one.
Yeah, Taoiseach, the fact that you're not able to answer my question indicates the case I made that the government doesn't believe there's an emergency in homelessness. And this is the second week in a row that you haven't been able to answer a question. I asked you last week about services for citizens with mental health problems. The figures I give you are absolutely up to date. In the last year, you were offered 1,800 homes. Fact. You only took up 600 of those offers. Fact. And the other is that I asserted that over 8,000 people are homeless and 3,194 are children. There are 300 more children in emergency accommodation, Taoiseach, since you became Taoiseach. It hasn't got better, it has got worse. So, will you explain to the Dáil, and if you can't do it now, will you make it a point to come back in here to explain to the Dáil why you're purchasing only 600 of the 1,800 homes on offer, why it's taken so long to purchase the ones that you are purchasing, and taken so long to allocate those homes to families?
Deputy, we all know how politics works. If you genuinely wanted an answer to that question, you could have got it by putting down a parliamentary question to the Minister for Housing. That is how you get an answer to a question of that nature. If you're going to ask the question without any notice to me at leaders' questions, well then obviously you know, if the purpose of the deputy's question was to actually get an answer, he could either have given me notice of the question or he could have put it down as a written question as a PQ to the line ministers. That is how you get an answer to a question if you genuinely want an answer. But I will give the deputy the best answer that I can give him. And that comes from the housing agency, which is purchasing 600 of the homes mentioned. And the Minister for Housing has already committed to Sinn Féin that he will examine the other homes to establish why the housing agency didn't purchase them. But the housing agency is the expert body when it comes to this matter, and it's their advice that is followed as to whether houses are suitable for social housing or not. But as I say, this matter has been raised with the Minister of Housing already. 600 of those homes are being purchased, and we have agreed that we will examine the others to see why they weren't suitable for purchase. But I would point out once again the contradiction in the position that is being put to us here again by Sinn Féin. Only last week and the week before, we get criticised for buying homes. We get told that this doesn't count, that all that matters is houses that are built directly by local authorities, that these are the only ones that count. If they're not direct built by local authorities, they don't matter. So the consistent argument for Sinn Féin for 2 weeks is that you shouldn't buy houses from developers. Only direct bill by local authorities count. And then they turn up the next week wanting to know why we're not buying more houses from private developers. You know, this is a party that is all over the place on everything.